watching the Samwelb B12 experience.
Welcome to the post-game show of the Leafs and the Vancouver Canucks, where Vancouver was able to take this one 6-4. It was quite the affair. The first period belonged to the Vancouver Canucks, scoring 3. Hoglander, his 13th from Lafferty and Hughes. Hoglander, his 14th from Amon and Garland. And then Garland, his 7th from Bluger and Joshua. The Maple Leafs were able to get things going in the second period as William Nylander found his first of 2 for his 22nd. Riley and Brody assisting that. Then it was Jake McCabe, his 3rd from Marner and Matthews. Finally, Nylander, his 2nd of the game, his 23rd from Riley. It was Garland then who struck at the end, his 8th from Bluger. The third period was back and forth. The Maple Leafs tying things up. Marner, his 20th on a shorthanded breakaway. A beautiful goal goes in unassisted. Then it was Miller, his 21st on the power play from Hughes and Pettersson. And then Pettersson, his 25th on the power play from Miller and Hughes. The officials calling 3 straight penalties on the Maple Leafs to start the third period. And that was enough for Vancouver to absolutely put it away. Toronto tried. Toronto battled hard, but they just didn't have enough. They just didn't have enough to get it done. But it was a valiant effort as they came in and battled. They fell behind early. They worked really, really hard at the end to try and pick this one up, but it just wasn't meant to be, unfortunately, for the Maple Leafs. It was Vancouver who was all over them. They played an unbelievable game. They came through and did an amazing, amazing job. If we go and we want to break down the game stats to see exactly what went down, here it is. The Vancouver Canucks, 21 shots. Toronto putting up 47 shots. 47 shots. Absolutely incredible. From a hit standpoint, it was Vancouver leading the way 34-26. It became a lot more physical as this game went on. From a faceoff percentage, Toronto 36 to Vancouver's 21. That equates to 61.8% for Toronto in the faceoff circle. But the big number is right over here in the middle of the screen. Toronto goes 0-5 on the power play. 2-3 is Vancouver. Now, there were a couple man advantages right at the end of the game. So really, they went 0-4. That last one doesn't really, really count. Giveaways, you see it there. 7 giveaways for Toronto. 1 listed for Vancouver. A lot of takeaways. 5 for Vancouver, 4 to Toronto. The block shots making a big difference. 19 for Vancouver, 14 for Toronto. So a nice job there blocking some shots. And that really, really, really makes a whopping difference. It's tough when you're getting that many shots, and when you're having them blocked, it makes a big, big difference. So one thing we have to look at is who were the players in tonight's game? Who are the players that stood out? Who deserves the accolades for this one? And well, it is, should I leave it as a surprise? Should I leave it as a surprise? Nah. Your 3 stars for tonight's game are, boom, Connor Garland. He is going to walk away with star number 1. He had a pretty, pretty doozy of a game. 2 goals, an assist, 3 points on the night. William Nylander, star number 2. He wakes up and has a great effort. 2 goals tonight. Not a great first period, but when Willie awoke, Willie awoke. And then Hoglander as well, 3rd star tonight. He picks up 2 goals for 2 points. This was a tough one. There are some honorable mentions that we have to go around. Mitch Marner, he gets an honorable mention tonight. He came up with a goal and an assist, 2 points. He had that shorthanded goal. He also walked away with 5 shots. in 23 minutes. Matthews, of course, he played a decent game. He had 7 shots. He threw a couple of hits as well. A couple of players who really struggled tonight. Domi, he played okay. You know, he had 6 hits tonight, but he struggled, and I don't necessarily blame Domi for his struggles tonight. I think I put it more on his line mates. Nyes had a very tough game tonight. He struggled. He was being hit and worked around very physically. Nyes struggled. Yarncroc struggled tonight. Tyler Bertuzzi, John Tavares continuing to struggle. So they did not do really, really well. Michael, welcome in. It was the Vancouver Canucks taking this one 6-4 in an entertaining game, a very entertaining game. But as I was saying, John Tavares really struggled. Bertuzzi really struggled. Bertuzzi ends up only playing 13 minutes of this game. Bertuzzi did sacrifice another tooth today as he got knocked down and had a tooth get knocked out and was a little bloody. The fourth line really, really struggled. McMahon, Kempf, and Gregor struggled. But the defense was not good. TJ Brody had a lot of challenges in tonight's game. Giordano, a lot of challenges defending this very quick defensive team. Riley did as much as he could do. Riley led the way in minutes for all defenders at 23 and a half minutes of ice time today. 10 shots by Morgan Riley, which is pretty awesome. He did pick up 2 penalties and had a couple of assists in tonight's game. Liljegren struggled a little bit. McCabe and Benoit, I thought, played okay. They each, McCabe 18 or almost 19 minutes, Benoit about 13 and a half minutes of ice time. Marty Jones in net tonight for Toronto did not have his best outing, that's for sure, but I don't blame a lot of those goals on him. The team in front of him really, really did let Jonesy down. Vancouver, on the other hand, quite a nice all-around game. Even though Besser ended up a -2 tonight, a good effort. He was really skating. Connor Garland, he looked great. Miller looked great. Sam Lafferty, boy, we wish he was still here in Toronto. Sam Lafferty, another nice game. 3 hits. He's 50% in the faceoff circle. It's tough to find a Vancouver player who struggled tonight. Pettersson looking good, as always. Blueger had himself a nice game. Mikheyev, Joshua, everybody contributing a little bit. And Kuzmenko, the player who's been the subject of a lot of trade rumors, was involved in this game a lot, in the play, doing a lot of nice things. From a defensive side, Soucy, he was a -3 tonight, so if anybody struggled, it was him. But he was mixing it up. He was getting under the skin of a lot of the Leaf players today. Leading Vancouver in minutes from a defensive standpoint was Tyler Myers and Roenick. Tyler Myers, boy, was he dishing it out. He was all over these Leafs, dumping them all over the place. But really, the difference maker, besides the poor play of the Leafs, Thatcher Demko. Demko was incredible. Even though, I say incredible, he gave up 4 goals, and some of them were not pretty. But when the time mattered, listen, 47 shots, he stopped 43 of them. He still walks away with a .915 save percentage. Thatcher Demko was the difference maker. At his large frame to shut down this team, he did an absolutely excellent job when he needed to. Now, a lot of things happened in this game. If we walk through them, William Nylander, he snapped his 6-game goal drought. He also became the 4th fastest player in Leaf franchise history to reach the 60-point mark in the season. That's good for him. Jake McCabe, who tried to cut the Leaf down, he was trying to get in there to create a multi-goal comeback win in consecutive games. That didn't come to fruition. But William Nylander, he notched his 200th NHL goal, which was nice to see him get done and get going. So congrats, Willie, on your 200th NHL goal. Also to note that he moves within 9 of matching his father's career totals. His father, Michael Nylander, totaled 209 during his 15-year career, which is pretty cool. Morgan Riley picking up 2 assists and has 8 career points in Hockey Day in Canada games, which is the third most by defensemen in the NHL, just behind Erik Karlsson and Dion Phaneuf. Mitch Marner, he got a couple of points and now recorded his 6th 20-goal season of his NHL career and 4th consecutive. Marner scored his 9th career shorthanded goal to pass Daryl Sittler and George Armstrong and to tie Mark Osborne and Dan Daou for 11th place on the franchise's all-time list, which is pretty neat. Quinn Hughes for Vancouver collected 3 assists in a game for the 7th time this season, becoming the 6th defenseman in NHL history with as many in one campaign. The others who did it, Paul Coffey, Bobby Orr, Ray Bourque, Phil Housley, and Roman Josi. The other thing with Quinn Hughes is he's joined Henrik Sedin as just the 2nd player in Canucks history with 7 3-assist outings in a single season. This is the 70th multi-point game of Quinn Hughes' career. So that is pretty darn incredible. Taking a look around the league at all the scores at this point, your finals, the Lightning 3-1 over the Sabres, the Avalanche 7-4 over the Flyers, the Predators lose 3-2 to the Coyotes, the Jets win it in overtime 2-1 over the Senators, the Bruins downing the Montreal Canadiens 9-4, the Stars 6-2 over the Devils, and here, Toronto loses to Vancouver 6-4. Currently, at the end of the second, the Blues are up 2-0 over the Washington Capitals. Those are your out-of-town scores at this time, 10 o'clock Eastern, on Saturday, January 20th. So thank you, everybody, for hanging around and watching around. Let's go to your comments. Let's see your thoughts on this game. Leafs played the Canucks in the second and third, 47 shots. Curtis, yes, that is amazing. They put up 47 shots, but they just could not get it done. They absolutely could not. Feel Sammy gets pulled in the first period and we lose very bad. I'm very jaded after this many years of watching Toronto. Yes, Lee, it is tough. It's tough to see that many goals go in. Absolutely. And Samsonov has not been stellar. They give Martin Jones here a little bit of a longer leash because Jones has played quite well. And as I said, I don't really think it was Jones's fault for how this played out. It was more the team in front of him. They kind of let him down. It was not good. Tomorrow night, the 21st, the Leafs in the Kraken. Mark says we win tomorrow. It's going to be on a different level. We'll have to wait and see. That should be a really good game. Of course, we will be here live on the channel doing the Seattle Kraken game play-by-play. So make sure you tune in for all the Leafs action. Bertuzzi should have a nice bonus under his belt. The lone stranger, Bertuzzi, struggling. And I'm curious, what is it going to take for Bertuzzi to find his game and get going? He's had a lot of chances. But when is coach going to sit him, move him? And when I mean sit him, not just a period, put him in the press box for a game. Let's get Nick Robertson back out here. Every game Nick Robertson has played, yes, he's a little bit of a defensive liability, but he's fast, he skates, he works hard, and he's been scoring some goals, and him and Domi have a real chemistry together. So I think it's about time we get Nick Robertson back in. I think it's about time we get William Lagesson back in. It's time this Leafs team really shake things up and not just pretend by saying we hold people accountable and not doing much. All right, that's going to do it as we're going to wrap up this post-game show. Thank you so much for hanging out with us for tonight's game. I hope you enjoyed our post-game coverage. We'll see you tomorrow night, the Leafs and the Seattle Kraken. Until then, be good, and we'll see you real soon. Again, Leafs lose to the Vancouver Canucks tonight, 6-4. Time to turn it around. Go Leafs, go. Take care, everybody. From the Samwelb B12 post-game show, good night. We'll see you tomorrow. Samwelb B12 experience.